Hate Speech Laws by Daniel J. Towsey. Hate speech laws are actually cleverly written deceptions that create and promote hate. They create a hate for free thought and inquisition into human activities and history. Hate of any kind is the single worst human trait anyone can ever possess. I always tell people that hate kills the soul of the one who truly has it in their intellectual being. So ask yourself the next time you read or hear something you do not agree with. Do you exhibit traits of hate or understanding? Ignorance of truth breeds hatred. When you hear or read something you do not agree with, do you go out and research what the messenger has said, or do you ignorantly bring out your hate and attack the messenger of truth? Please read my introspection, The Village Idiot, and Allusions articles for further understanding. Hate speech laws were created by those evildoers who hate those that pursue the hidden truths. Hate speech laws are actually detrimental to a free and open democratic people's society. Hate speech laws kill intellectual thought. Hate speech laws are to keep the sheeple in line for the purposes of the New World Order masters of deception. The masters of deception long ago figured out that they are able to carry out their evil if they keep the masses dumb and stupid. They do this by making sure that the masses never have access to alternative free thought and knowledge. For as long as the people do not have access to the truth and free speech, they will be slaves to the New World Order controllers. After all, knowledge of the occult empowers the people. Please read my occult article. A couple of days ago, a very important thing happened here in Canada. A judge threw out all of Canada's hate speech laws and ruled them as unconstitutional. Wow! We now have a truly free and open society. Power to the people, and thanks to all the truth soldiers. Please read the related articles. Canada has a new hero, and this is a huge victory. Ernst Zundel, a true hero and fighter for truth and liberty, immigrated to Canada, the land of the free and the brave. Because like many others from all over the world, he wanted to be part of our proud heritage of truth, justice, and liberty for all. But unfortunately, after free trade and the NAFTA agreement, Canada began to stop protecting everything that our Canadian ancestors created for us. We began by losing free speech that actually protected our freedoms. Then we lost control of our laws. Then we lost all our public utilities. Then we lost control of our natural resources. Then, we piece by piece lost our soul and reputation for being a society of wonderful, loving, and generous peoples. But without truth, there can never be love for anything that is beautiful. Canada began to go down the path of oppression and evil that has been brought in by the masters of deception and their agenda to take over the world by means of taking control of all money-making and financial institutions of the world. They were able to covertly do this by the criminal creation of the privately owned and controlled Federal Reserve of the United States of America. They then created the First World War and went about their slaughter of innocent, unsuspecting peoples of the world. Please realize that they have had the ability to create money out of thin air and have never been scrutinized by the people. Please read my The Last Democracy for a better understanding, and then read The Last Democracy is Dead. If humanity survives this, one day in the free future, the creation of the Federal Reserve will be known for what it is: the single worst crime ever committed against humanity in all of human history. For more understanding, please read my Are You Ready for the Truth? And Recipe for Insanity articles. In 1984, I lived in the riding of York Center in the city of North York of Toronto, Canada. I was young, intelligent, and very naive as to the workings and evils of this big world. I was very busy working for democracy. I was working on my friend the lawyer Michael Cohen's federal election campaign. At the time, he was a member of the Progressive Conservative Party. We were running his election against the then Solicitor General of Canada, known as Bob Kaplan of the Liberal Party. I then became a victim of very serious crimes against truth, justice, and liberty at the hands of Bob Kaplan and his newly created secret police known as CSIS, Canadian Secret Intelligence Service, a division of the Royal Canadian Mounted Police. Please read my related article, Corrupt Canadian Elections. At this time, the Solicitor General, CSIS, and the corporate media were attacking a fellow truth soldier in the war against evil and deceptions. I am talking about Ernst Zundel. You can learn more about him at Zundel's site. He was charged under hate laws for spreading false news. He won his Holocaust trial because his opposition could not bring to court any proof of their claims. And all their so-called Holocaust witnesses were proven to be lying. He lost his second trial and on appeal to Canada's Supreme Court. The law was thrown out as being against the Canadian Constitution. But the corrupt media never reported the importance of his trials to the people. Instead, they ignorantly hated Ernst Zundel and went on a media campaign to destroy this true intellectual and humanist. Ernst Zundel and my exposure to absolute evil while working on my federal election campaign woke me up to the horrible realization of the huge deceptions and evil that was being perpetrated against humanity worldwide. Thanks to Ernst Zundel, I have been on a path to seek more truth. Thank you, Ernst Zundel, for your never-ending love for truth and your huge sacrifice to humanity. Ernst Zundel had to do something that brought so much pain to my heart and love for Canada. He had to leave Canada. He moved to the United States of America and married his beloved in Greatham Land. But the evil from Canada chased after him. He was illegal to kidnap my government spooks, taken to Niagara Falls, USA, and presented to a judge who ruled that he could not return to the USA for 20 years. He was then brought to Toronto and put in solitary confinement for 2 years without being charged with anything. Then secret hearings were held against him where he was not allowed to face his accusers and was not allowed to present any truths in his defense. He was not allowed to know or hear the accusations against him. The judge ruled that truth is not a defense. This broke my heart. For my love of Canada and our heritage of truth, justice, and liberty was shattered. Ernst Zundel was later kidnapped again and sent to Germany, where revisionist truth is absolutely not allowed. Our fellow brother and honorary Canadian has been kept in jail ever since, and Canada has lost another great visionary of truth. Thank you, Ernst Zundel and Ingrid, for your service to love and humanity. There can never be love without truth. www.scribe.com/danieltowsey. Hate speech laws.